Hello dear students, today our topic is complex number. It follows from the properties of real numbers that the square of a real number is never negative. So consequently, the elementary quadratic equation x square plus 1 equal to 0 has no solution in the system of real numbers. Belongs to R, real numbers. So, introduction of a new type of numbers called complex number has made it possible to provide the solutions of the equation x square plus 1 equal to 0 and also of the more general type of equation a naught x to the power n, a1 x to the power n minus 1 plus etc. an equal to 0, where a1, a2, an are belongs to R. So that made it possible for finding this type solution of this type of equations. So let us first define the complex number. A complex number Z is defined to be an ordered pair of real numbers A, B that satisfies the following condition 1 and the following laws of operations 2 and 3. So what is the condition 1? 1 is A, if A, B equal to C, D, if and only if A equal to C and B equal to D. So this first component equal to the first component of the second and second component equal to the second component. So this is if A, B equal to C, D, if and only if A equal to C, B equal to D. And operations 2 is sum of two ordered pairs, that is individually A plus C comma B plus D. And third is the product, third operation is the product of two ordered pairs, that is given by AC minus BD and AD comma AD plus BC. So we'll see later on the calculations. These are the one condition, number one is the condition and two laws of operations, addition and multiplication. Of the ordered pair AB, the first component is said to be the real part of Z and is denoted by real Z. And the second component B is said to be the imaginary part of Z and is denoted by imaginary of Z. So we sometimes write the complex number Z equal to A plus IB, where I is root over minus 1. This expression or notation iota, this is iota. So this expression is given by Euler, a famous mathematician. So this is the representation of complex number where A is the real part and B is the imaginary part because it is the multiplication with the iota. So this is real part, both are real numbers AB. But this is real part, this is imaginary part, or in terms of order pair we can express the complex number. So this is the formal definition of complex number. Now let us see what are the fundamental operations on complex number. Already we have observed that the addition of two complex number, suppose z1 is equal to a1 b1 and z2 is equal to a2 b2, then their addition is given by z1 plus z2 is equal to a1 plus a2 comma b1 plus b2. And subtraction, before subtraction we have to see the negative of a complex number z1 is minus z1 and defined to be the complex number z2 such that z1 plus z2 is equal to 0. Here 0 is a complex number, so 0 is 0 comma 0. 0 is a complex number. In real number it's a real line, but in complex number it will have two components 0 comma 0. So 0 denotes the complex number 0 comma 0. So z1 plus z2 equal to 0 implies a1 plus a2 comma b1 plus b2 is equal to 0 comma 0. So comparing a1 plus a2 is equal to 0, that gives you a2 is equal to minus 1 and b2 is equal to minus b1. So we have z2 is equal to minus a1 b1. So therefore minus of a1 b1 is equal to this. So that gives the negative of the complex number, that gives the idea of the negative of the complex number. Now you apply here z1 plus z1 minus z2, you have this relation. So we can write z1 minus z2 also z1 plus of minus z2. Clear? So this gives you the addition of two complex number, and this is the negative of two complex number, then this result follows. This result. So this gives you the subtraction and this gives you the addition. Now multiplication of two complex number, as we see in the definition of the complex numbers. Let us see the definition once again. So this is the operation. So this is the multiplicative operation and this is the addition operation. So there are two operations and one condition. So here also the multiplication is given by z1 z2 is equal to a1 a2 minus b1 b2 and a1 b2 plus b1 a2. So this is the multiplication operation. Now we'll check the addition and multiplications are associative, commutative or not. Yes, this addition is commutative. Why? Because you see z1 plus z2 equal to z2 plus z1, and for multiplication this is the commutative property. You see, if you add z1 z2, z1 plus z2, that is you are taking z1 first and z2 second, is the same if you take z2 first and z1 second. Again, if you see multiplication, the same thing, z1 dot z2 is equal to z2 dot z1. So this is called commutative law. As in the set theory, we see that A union B is equal to B union A, A intersection B is equal to B intersection, that is the property. So multiplication is also commutative. Now, what about the associative law? Z1 plus z, z1 plus first bracket z2 plus z3 is equal to, if you add z1 plus z2 and then z3, if you will get the same result. So this is called associative property. This is holds for multiplication also. So commutative and associative properties are holds for addition and multiplication. Now we'll define multiplicative inverse in complex number. For a non-zero complex number, that is z1 is not equal to 0 comma 0, non-zero means z1 not equal to 0 comma 0, that is not a origin. So for a non-zero complex number, z1 denoted by z1 minus z1 to the power minus is defined by the complex number z2 such that z1 z2 is equal to 1. This gives you the multiplicative inverse. Z1 z2 is equal to 1, in that case you will get z2 is equal to z1. So let us observe that. Now z1 z2 is equal to 1 implies, you already we mentioned that this is the multiplication, a1 a2 minus b1 b2 comma a1 b2 plus b1 a2 equal to 1 is nothing but your 1 0, because your real part is 1 and complex part is imaginary part is 0. So 1 can be written as 1 is equal to 1 plus I0. So the order pair is 1 0. So comparing, 1 0 is said to be the unit complex number and is denoted by 1. Okay, clear? So this is the representation. So this is equal to 1, comparing this equal to 1 and the second component equal to 0. So solving these two equations simultaneously for a2 b2 in terms of a1 b1, we'll easily see that a2 is equal to a1 by a1 square plus b1 square and b2 is equal to minus of this quantity, where a1, since non-zero complex number, we are talking about a non-zero complex number, z1 is non-zero and z1 is equal to a1 b1. Also observe that z1 is equal to a1 b1 and z2 is equal to a2 b2. Okay, so z1 is equal to a1 b1 and z2 is equal to a2 b2. We see that as a1 b1 not equal to 0 0, a2 b2 both exist because this is not equal to 0. So a1 b1 inverse is given by, because you have the result of a2 b2, so this is the multiplicative inverse. This is the multiplicative inverse from the z1 relation z1 z2 is equal to 1. So this gives you the multiplicative inverse. Now we'll see the division of two complex number. Later on we'll see in the geometrical sense the multiplication, addition, subtraction and the division. So division of two complex number where Z2 is a non-zero complex number, again Z1 by Z2, because Z2 is non-zero complex number, that is Z2 not equal to 0, 0. Here we mention that A2, B2 not equal to 0, 0. This is the restriction. So we have already the idea of multiplicative inverse. So we can get A2, B2 inverse here. So finally, the expressions for A2, B2 already we obtained in the previous section. Yes, this is the value. So substitute and get finally the multiplication using the multiplication property. Already we mentioned the multiplication property. This is the result. So now again we mentioned that complex number 0, 1, that is I. I can be written as it's an imaginary part. So I real part is 0 and imaginary part is 1. So we can write I is equal to 0 plus I into 1. So 0, 1. It is the imaginary unit and is divided by I. Again, I dot I is from using the multiplication property minus 1, 0. So this is minus 1. Or 0, B can be written as IB or BI. So the normal form of any complex number, what is the normal form? Normal form is nothing but your A plus IB. As already mentioned earlier, that any complex number Z can be written as A plus IB. This is also the definition of the complex number A comma IB, either in the form of A comma IB or in the form of order pair A comma B. So addition, now let us define more easiest way to addition, subtraction and multiplication. So addition of two complex number, look at that the addition A plus IB plus C plus ID, that is equal to A plus C plus I of B plus D. And multiplication of two complex number, that is A plus IB into C plus ID, that is equal to AC, if you multiply A into C plus I square BD. Look at that. You will get a term I square BD, and that gives you I square is equal to minus 1. So here you have AC minus BD as the real part, because if you expand, multiply, then you will get this term. And A into ID, that is IAD, and I into BC, that is if you take real part, this is your real part, because I square is minus 1 using the relation, and this is your imaginary part. So real part, imaginary part. Always, whatever we do, addition, subtraction, multiplication and division, will express the complex number in the form of A plus IB, that is real part and imaginary part, always. So this is real part, this is imaginary part. Also in terms of division, we take C minus ID as a multiplication. We'll explain this later on. So if you multiply, this is A plus IB into A minus IB, that gives you A square minus B square. Again, I square is equal to minus 1, so that gives you plus. And numerator multiplication in the similar process will give you the real part and the imaginary part. This is your real part and this is your imaginary part. So always we'll express the complex number in terms of real and imaginary part. Now let's come to the important part of the complex number, that is geometrical representation of a complex number. So geometrical representation of complex number is very important because it gives you a total idea. So let us take the, as in the complex number, as in the real numbers, we see the points on line. Okay, so this, in case of real numbers, this is the real axis, this is the axis x direction, and this is your x dash and negative direction, this is y direction, and this is negative y direction. But in case of complex number, this gives you real axis. This is same real numbers, because this represents the real number. This is in complex number represents the real axis, and this is your imaginary axis. Y is your imaginary axis. So this gives you the imaginary direction. So imaginary axis, positive imaginary axis, negative imaginary axis. So this is real axis, this is imaginary axis. And any order pair is a point on the complex plane, can be represented by a point in a plane. So any complex number is represented by a point in the complex number. So with respect to the rectangular Cartesian coordinate system in a plane, the complex number Z is equal to A plus IB can be represented by the point on the coordinates A comma B. Okay, just see this is your point A comma B. So complex number, that is Z is equal to A plus IB. So this gives you the real part A and imaginary part B. So this horizontal and this is vertical. So this represents the position of the point AB. So this is how you represent the complex number by a plane. Okay, so real axis, we talked about real axis and imaginary axis. Now the plane in which this representation is made is said to be the complex plane or the Argand plane or the famous mathematician Gaussian plane. German mathematician, it's a famous mathematician. According to his name, he has done a lot of development, and this is called Gaussian plane or complex plane or Argand plane. Okay, now we define the conjugate of a complex number. So what is the conjugate of a complex number? Conjugate of a complex number is denoted by Z bar and is defined to be the complex number A minus IB if Z is equal to A plus IB. So you have a complex number Z is equal to A plus IB. Its conjugate is defined by A minus IB and denoted by Z bar is equal to A minus IB. So look at that geometrical position of the complex number Z is equal to A minus. So this is your Z and this is your Z bar. If you take a reflection on the real axis, this is gives your Z bar. So Z bar is A minus IB. So this is your complex number, conjugate of a complex number. So conjugate of a complex number is nothing but the reflection on the real axis. So if this is Z, this is your Z bar. This is the position of Z bar. That is reflection of the complex number Z. And if this angle is theta, this angle is also theta. So in this case, this A, this is minus B. Okay. So this gives you the conjugate of a complex number. Some properties of a conjugate of a complex number. Z bar bar, if you take Z bar bar, that will be Z. Z bar plus minus Z2 whole bar is equal to Z bar plus minus Z2 bar. That is, the bar is splitted. And Z1 dot Z2 bar whole bar is multiplication again. Z individual Z1 bar into Z2 bar. And division in case of, in this case also, Z1 bar by Z2 bar whole bar, and provided Z2 not equal to 0. That is, Z2 is not equal to 0, 0, non-zero complex number. And if you take Z plus Z bar, that will give you two real part of Z. Look at that. If you add these two, Z plus Z bar, BI, BI cancel, and you will get the 2A. That is the two real part of Z. And Z minus Z bar will give you 2I imaginary part of Z. And Z1 dot Z2 is a purely real. If you multiply, you will get A square plus B square. Because A plus IB is equal to into A minus IB is equal to A square plus I square B square. I square is nothing but your minus, minus 1. So minus 1 plus, it will give a real part, purely real. Now modulus of a complex number. So modulus of a complex number is denoted by non-negative real number root over A square plus B square. That is, the real part square plus imaginary part square, positive, is said to be the absolute value or the modulus of Z and is denoted by mod Z or mod Z, MODZ. So let us draw the diagram and see the modulus again. So this is your real axis, imaginary axis, and this is your Z complex number, that is A comma B, and this is your origin, zero complex number, and this is your real axis, this is your imaginary axis. So what is modulus? Modulus is of the distance of the complex number from the origin. That is, this distance is denoted by mod Z. So mod Z is equal to root over A square plus B square. That is the distance of the complex number from origin. So every point on the plane, complex plane or Argand plane or Gaussian plane, we have a modulus. That is the distance of that complex number from origin we can measure. So this is the value of that modulus. So this gives us a geometrical idea of the conjugate of a complex number and also the modulus of a complex number. Okay. Now let's come to the last section, that is the polar form of a complex number. Again, for polar form, we have to draw a diagram. So again, we are representing a complex number P, X, Y. Suppose this is real axis and this is imaginary axis. So this distance is x and this vertical distance is y. And look at that, the complex point is P in the complex plane, and this, suppose this angle is theta and this is R. This R modulus is denoted by R mod Z. R is nothing but your mod Z, and it is positive, always positive. So we can write x is equal to, or a is equal to r cos theta. So here we have written a is equal to r cos theta and b is equal to r sin theta. Look at that diagram. From this diagram we can write x is equal to r cos theta, okay, and y is equal to r sin theta, so we can write the complex number z is equal to r into cos theta plus I sin theta in terms of R theta. This is called polar representation of the complex number. Now, so R is said to be the modulus of Z. This is the polar representation. Look at that, R and theta, not in terms of X and Y or AB, whatever be your notation. Now look at that, theta is the angle made by the radius vector through the point AB with the real axis. Theta is called the argument or amplitude of Z. So theta is called the argument or amplitude of Z, okay. Now, very important observation, for a non-zero complex number Z, theta has infinitely many values differing from one another by multiple of 2 pi. Look at that. If you rotate the angle theta, so you have multiple of 2 pi. So one angle is differing from another by a multiple of 2 pi. Okay, there are so many angles, infinite number of angles we can get. So differing from 2 pi. Now, we have a restriction on that angle. So those values are called general values, but we'll stick to some principal values. Let us follow. So now look at that calculation. Z is equal to a plus ib r cos theta plus I sin theta. We can write r e to the power I theta. Look at that representation. This is written as e to the power I theta. That is called Euler form. Euler form. E to the power I theta is equal to cos theta plus I sin theta. So this is one of the representation. This is very shortest way to write the complex number, where r cos theta is equal to a and r sin theta is equal to b, or x and y. So simply this gives you r is equal to a square root over a square plus b square, because modulus of this complex number, and theta is determined from the relation cos theta is equal to a by r, sin theta is equal to b by r. Both the relation will determine theta, not a single relation. From these two relation also we can write theta is equal to tan inverse y by x. So both the relation will determine theta, okay. So now let's come to the, so what is your, I was talking about principal argument or principal amplitude, because if you rotate the angle, that those gives you the general values differing from 2 pi, but we'll restrict ourselves to some specific value. That value is known as principal value or principal argument or principal amplitude of Z, and is denoted by arg or amp of Z, and is denoted by the angle which satisfies the inequality minus pi less than theta less than equal to pi. Minus pi less than theta less than equal to pi is the range. So now let us study the cases. If the point is in the first quadrant, if the point is in the first quadrant, then x is positive and y is positive. So in this case, look at the diagram, your theta is given by alpha. So here both the things are positive, so it will satisfy the this relation, because your range is minus pi to pi. So argument is given by tan inverse y by x. In this case, you're simply that relation is given by theta. So already we mentioned this is your theta. In this case, in the first quadrant, that gives you the amplitude or argument of Z. So that is given by argument of Z is equal to tan inverse y by x. It's clear. So this is in the first case. If both the points are in the positive quadrant, first quadrant, that is your point in the first quadrant complex plane, then it will give you argument straightforward tan inverse y by x. But if it is in the second quadrant, then look at that, this is your alpha, then this gives you pi minus alpha, So this is your pi minus alpha. Theta is your pi minus alpha. So in this case, x is negative and y is positive. So argument is given by pi minus alpha because it will satisfy this inequality, minus pi less than theta less than equal to pi, because your principal range cannot be beyond this range. It will always include it in that range, and where alpha is given by tan inverse mod of y by x, because x is negative, so you have to take modulus. So in this case, your argument is given by pi minus alpha in the second quadrant. In the first quadrant, argument is tan inverse y by x, that is alpha. Look at the third case. Third case, x is negative, third quadrant, that is your complex point lies in the third quadrant. Both are negative, x negative, y negative. So in this case, we cannot go like this because it will cross the range this pi. So we have to go clockwise direction. So that is why there is a negative. Theta is given by minus of pi minus alpha. Look at that. If this is alpha, this is your pi minus of pi minus alpha. Minus of pi minus alpha. So your argument is given by alpha minus pi, and alpha is again tan inverse mod of y by x, because both are negative. So once again I repeat, if your point lies on the third quadrant, that is x is negative and y is negative, your argument is given by alpha minus pi. So alpha is your tan inverse y by x, because it will cross that beyond that range, principal range. So you have to go clockwise direction. So that gives you argument alpha minus pi, and alpha is tan inverse mod y by x. So last quadrant, that is in the fourth quadrant, if your complex plane, complex point is in the fourth quadrant of the complex plane, then p is given by this, and this gives you the clockwise direction. Theta is equal to minus alpha because you are going clockwise, otherwise it will beyond that range of principal values. So in this case, both are negative, so argument is given by very simple minus alpha, where alpha is again tan inverse y by x mod, because y is negative. So this gives you the fourth quadrant. So once again I summarize. First quadrant, your argument is tan inverse y by x, not in all the quadrant this value. In the second quadrant, it will be pi minus alpha, where alpha is tan inverse mod y by x. In the third quadrant, it will be alpha minus pi, where alpha is tan inverse mod y by x. And in the fourth quadrant, argument is minus alpha, where alpha is tan inverse again mod y by x. So this gives you the complete polar form, and in all the quadrants what will be the your argument, and in all the cases your modulus is r is equal to root over a square plus b square. So this gives you the complete geometrical idea of polar form. Okay, and always remember that your principal value is minus pi to pi, and all other values are the general values, and we also separate the cases and for clear understanding the diagram. So I hope this video is very helpful to you. So please follow my videos and subscribe my channel for the I will post the next video of the complex number for second class. Thank you.